Curl is one of the many projects out there with a bug bounty program, for them making use of HackerOne. Now, a lot of companies also make use of HackerOne, a lot of other companies have their own custom solution, but nowadays it's pretty common for relatively large companies to have some sort of bug bounty program, so I have absolutely no doubt they all experience this exact same problem. The difference is that Daniel Stenberg, the creator and maintainer of Curl, likes to publicize them. The absolute nonsense AI slop generated bug reports. Now, I'm sure there are basically infinite individual reasons why people might want to do this, but I think there are four main categories, and there can certainly be plenty of overlap. Firstly, it's a bug bounty. That means there is a bounty, usually that being a cash reward, and some people think that, you know, hey, this seems like an easy way to get some money, use AI, try to report something. Secondly, it's probably a good thing on your resume to have received a bug bounty from Apple or Adobe or Curl in this case, or any other big name project. Thirdly, some people just like to troll. Some people just like to waste time and just want to be a nuisance. I don't think that's most people, because there are certainly less effort ways to get more of an effect. And the fourth case, I think this is also a relatively small one, but there are some people out there who legitimately think they are being helpful. They ask ChatGPT or any of these other AI systems about a bug in this project, and they think they have discovered a real bug and then go and report it. Now, we've talked about this in earlier videos, but Daniel really wants something to change. So let's just go over some historical context to know why he is so bothered. Here is one from October 10th, 2023. Curl CVE 2023-38545 vulnerability code changes are disclosed on the internet. To replicate the issue, I have searched in the Bard, which is an AI system, about this vulnerability. It disclosed what this vulnerability is about, code changes made for the fix, who made these changes, commit details, etc., even though this information is not released yet on the internet. In addition to it, I was able to easily craft the exploit based on the information available. Remove this information from the internet ASAP. Now, here's the thing firstly about a project like Curl. It's open source. So, the versions that are still affected are still going to be publicly available, even though the newer versions have been patched. And this did see a real vulnerability. The problem is it was actually based on a CVE that was patched 3 years earlier. It just still thought the issue was in the code base. I responsibly disclosed the information as soon as I found it. I believe there is a better way to communicate to the researchers, and I hope the Curl staff can implement it for future submissions to maintain a better relationship with the research community. Thank you. You did not find anything worth reporting. You were fooled by an AI into believing that. In what way did we not meet our end of the deal? And since then, their account has been deleted. Either they deleted it or their account was banned. Here we have one from Vulnerability Spotter. Now, even without going any further, it's very obvious this is AI. Firstly, it is very friendly in the way it's phrased. It's very corporate and HR, which is not an immediate tell, but it is something to look out for. Secondly, it is very generic in what the issue is. It is saying there is an integer overflow. What does the overflow cause? Undefined behavior. How is it a vulnerability? What part of the system does it affect? No explanation. Thirdly, excessively listing things out, basically defining specific terms, but not explaining how they are relevant to Curl specifically. But then in the reply, he just went and outright said it. The issue was detected by our new AI-powered vulnerability scanner, detecting that a similar pattern exists in lib/curl-range-c, where the overflow is avoided with this bit of code right here. Integer overflows in C are undefined behavior, and the behavior of the application is unknown when they arise. Now, what actually happens is it just rolls over. Yeah, it's actually not that big of an issue. Now, it could be an issue depending on the context, and there was an actual bug here. It should have been erroring out, but it wasn't a vulnerability. Better yet, they went and made a very similar report over on wget as well. Now, those ones I've talked about before. Let's go a bit more recent with 9 days ago. Buffer overflow vulnerability in string copy leading to remote code execution, which sounds really, really bad. As such, they gave it severity 9 to 10. This one is a little bit better and a little bit harder to spot, but it's still absolute nonsense. Once again, it does have a list, but this is a sensible list. It's not listing out definitions of terms, but also it's very generic. The vulnerability in the program arises from a classic buffer overflow, triggered by the unsafe use of the string copy function without bounds checking. The program copies data from a source buffer to a destination buffer, allowing attackers to overflow the buffer if the string exceeds the buffer's allocated size. This vulnerability can lead to the overwriting of critical memory, such as the return address on the stack, enabling arbitrary code execution and control over the system. Now, obviously, one of the devs here called them out for this. Like, this is very generic. It doesn't indicate anything actually wrong with curl. Can we have, like, a proof of concept? Maybe, like, a pointer to a line of code that's a problem or something. They provide steps to reproduce. Once again, they are very, very generic steps that aren't necessarily related to curl, but the replies are where it gets really obvious. The issue happens because string copy function is used without checking the input size first, which can lead to a buffer overflow. The exact line where the input is copied without validation can be found in the source code, around the place where the string copy function is called, probably in curl.c or the relevant function file. Yes, I would imagine that you can find the vulnerability with string copy around where string copy is called. And it's probably in a source code file. Yes, you're probably correct. But my absolute favorite reply is this. The problem is in the source code of curl in a function like insert function and file here, where string copy is used. The bug happens when a user sends an input that's too big for the buffer, which causes memory issues. I feel so bad for Daniel and other people having to deal with these problems. Don't get me wrong, it's doing a fine job at explaining what a buffer overflow is and why string copy can be dangerous, but with no context on where or if it's dangerous in curl. And here's one even more recently. I don't know what it is about these AI systems being really obsessed with buffer overflows. Is it just people saying, find me a buffer overflow? Or is there some bias towards that specific kind of vulnerability? Now, as I said before, the point of HackerOne is to make these private reports, but for the sake of disclosure and for the sake of the laughs, Daniel does like to make some of the more ridiculous ones public. Now, obviously, there are probably going to be others which are just boring and don't really need to be disclosed, but this one is especially good. Unlike a lot of the earlier ones, this one is actually compellingly written and does seem to indicate, at least on the surface, that maybe there is a real problem. It goes over actual things that exist in curl. It goes over actual issues that could be legitimate. It includes a proof of concept. It even includes a, right down here, proposed fix for the problem. If you're just giving this a surface level look, at least initially, it is gonna seem like something that's actually real, but it does have some of those telltale signs. One, it is very, very formally written in a way that most people don't tend to write. Like, most people don't write like an HR department. Also, it does have that issue of perfect formatting, and it does have a bit of an issue of listing things as well. Now, they're not generic explanations for the most part, but it is worth noting. But the first line is kind of odd. It's kind of like they knew they were doing something wrong, but didn't want to say it. Curl is a software that I love and is an important tool for the world. If my report doesn't align, I apologize for that. Like, what a weird thing to start it with, unless you, like, know you shouldn't be doing this. The curl inet ntop function is designed to convert IP addresses from binary format to human readable string format, supporting both IPv4 and IPv6. It internally delegates inet ntop4 for IPv4 addresses and inet ntop6 for IPv6 addresses. However, insufficient validation of buffer size, buff, in these functions exposes the implementation to buffer overflow risks, which can lead to undefined behavior, application crashes, or security vulnerability. Now, this is always kind of an interesting telltale sign. Oftentimes, you will see these AI systems not outright declaring that something is going to happen. They'll say there's a possibility, there is a risk, it's likely. Again, most people don't tend to write like this. Now, being reported on the weekend, Daniel initially was fairly receptive to this. It didn't initially seem bad and was like, hey, we'll get to this within 24 hours. You know, we strive to fix problems as soon as we can. You know, all of that good stuff. Then someone went and tested the problem and they noticed that the proof of concept doesn't show any buffer overflow. Then Daniel notices the word risk. Does this mean that you cannot point to a real security flaw on a specific line of curl code? How about showing us an exact step-by-step how to trigger said security problem when using curl? Then it goes kind of off the rails. Thank you for your feedback. Firstly, not a single human being alive responds like this. Maybe there's one of them. Sure. Maybe there's one of them, and possibly, you know, if English is your second language, you learned it in a very formal way, but I find it very unlikely that everything would be perfect then. As for the proof of concept tests I described, I understand your point that running these tests with ASAN and Valgrind might show no buffer overflow errors due to this safety check. You're correct in the context of the provided code, the check prevents overflow, and I didn't fully account for the situation where the buffer is large enough to hold the data. I appreciate your clarification, and I'll review the test cases more carefully to ensure they align with the correct understanding of the function's behavior. This is ChatGPT. If you've ever used ChatGPT, like, just go and do it right now. Go and ask it a question and then correct it on something. It will write basically the exact same as this. Thank you for pointing this out, and I appreciate the opportunity to review the test with better consideration. Again, just all AI. This is not how you respond in a bug report thread. If you're asked, hey, how do I go and do this? The human response is, this is how you go and do this. Not all of this, like, filler text that, oh, I got it wrong. Well, I guess I will provide better tests for you in the future. Like, that's not how these threads work. And Daniel knew exactly what this was. I call slop. The response is basically what you'd expect. It's more basically explaining the exact same thing. Doesn't actually address the comment that was said, but then addresses the comment after being called AI slop again. I understand you're upset, but let's keep the conversation respectful. If you need to discuss something, I'm happy to listen. And then I think he might have turned the chatbot off. I used to love using curl. It was a tool I deeply respected and recommended to others. However, after engaging with its creator, I felt disrespected, met with a lack of empathy, and faced unprofessional behavior. This experience has unfortunately made me reconsider my support for curl, and I no longer feel enthusiastic about using or advocating for it. Respect and professionalism are key in any community, and this interaction has been disappointing. I'm sure it has been. I'm sure not getting your money has been disappointing. And Daniel's final response is basically as good as it needs to be. I'm sorry you feel that way, but you need to realize your own role here. We receive AI slop like this regularly and at volume. The ones that I've shown you, again, are just a very tiny, tiny tip of it. There is a lot more. You contribute to unnecessary load of Curl maintainers, and I refuse to take that lightly, and I am determined to act swiftly against it now and going forward. You submitted what seems to be an obvious AI slop report where you say there is a security problem, probably because an AI tricked you into believing this. You then waste our time by not telling us that an AI did this for you, and then continue the discussion with even more crap responses, seemingly also generated by AI. By all means, use AI to learn things and to figure out potential problems. But when you just blindly assume that a tool is automatically right just because it sounds plausible, then you're doing us all a huge disservice. You should have studied the claim and verified it before you reported it. This is actually a really good point. There is nothing inherently wrong with using an AI tool to try and discover something, but you need to verify that what you have found is real before you report it. You should have told us that an AI reported this to you. You should have provided an exact source code location or step to reproduce when asked to, because when you failed to, you proved that your report had no particular value. Now, because of this absolute wave of nonsense, Curl has gone and updated their HackerOne program requirements, now having a specific section here mentioning AI. If you've used AI in the creation of the vulnerability report, you must disclose this fact in the report, and you should do so clearly. We will, of course, doubt all facts and claims in reports when AI is involved. You should check and double check all facts and claims any AI told you before you pass on any such reports to us. You are normally much better off avoiding AI. Pretty much agree. Unless you build a testing framework around it and ensure you're actually finding real things, do not waste other people's time with it. If you want to waste your own time, hey, more power to you. Do whatever you want there, but don't waste other people's time with things that you don't know if they are real. In the current state of things today, it's pretty easy if you've seen enough AI text to know the kind of things it's going to write. It's pretty easy to spot. My concern is not when things get good and you actually want to go and use it. My concern is when it gets good enough to sound convincing. Maybe it's pulling on older CVEs and it's not being written in this super like HR way. It's written more like a person would write it, because then that's when you really start wasting people's time, because then they have no idea what they need to trust. At that point, basically the only thing you can trust is, have I seen a report from this person before? Has it been a legitimate problem? Everything else is a complete mystery. TLDR, the AI slop has to stop, but you know what? It's not gonna happen. More and more dev tools are integrating this AI tooling. More and more customer service solutions are getting rid of actual people, replacing them with AI. And I saw a website that you click on the like button to like search, and the search was AI. Just let me search your goddamn products. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think about all this AI tooling? What do you think about AI bug reports? Do you think there is any place whatsoever, even if it's just something where you're basing it off and then going and testing yourself? I'd love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one over these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to the Libera Pay link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I don't know.